Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial, Linear Algebra Classes. In this video, we discuss about one very very important theorem. Dimension of V by W is equals to dimension of V minus dimension of W. One of the lengthiest theorem, but it is very very important to your end semester examination. Observe the statement, W be a subspace of a finite dimensional vector space V of F. Then, dimension of V by W is equals to dimension of V minus dimension of W. By data, V of F be a finite dimensional vector space. V of F be a finite dimensional vector space. And W is a subspace of V of F. Since V of F is finite dimensional, its every subspace is also finite dimensional. Observe the point. If V of F is a finite dimensional vector space, then every subspace of V of F is also finite dimensional. Therefore, W is also finite dimensional. What is mean by finite dimension? It has a finite basis. So W has a finite basis. Let it be. The finite basis of W is capital B is equals to beta 1, beta 2 and so on, beta n. It means capital B is a basis of W, finite basis of W. And it contains n elements. By the definition of basis, capital B is a linearly independent set. By the definition of basis, B is linearly independent. As well as dimension of W is equals to n. You remember that point. What is mean by dimension? What is mean by dimension? Dimension means the number of elements in the basis. The number of elements in the basis. Here dimension of W is equals to n. Because capital B is a basis of W. It contains n elements. It contains n elements. So dimension of W is equals to n. Remember that point. Dimension of W is equals to n. This is again very very important point. Every basis is a linearly independent set. Observe that. Capital B is linearly independent subset of W, which is subset to V. It means capital B is linearly independent subset of V. Capital B is linearly independent subset of V. This is very trivial point. Now there is very very important point. Every linearly independent set is itself a basis or it can be extended to form a basis. I repeat, every linearly independent set is itself a basis or it can be extended to form a basis. We use the extension. B can be extended to form a basis of V of F because B is linearly independent subset of V. Then B can be extended to form a basis of V of F. Let capital S is equals to beta 1, beta 2 and so on, beta n. Gamma 1, gamma 2 and so on, gamma n. Be an extension of B. Be an extension of B. What is mean by extension? We join some elements which are not lies in capital B. Which already not lies in capital B. We add some elements, gamma 1, gamma 2 and so on, gamma m to the set capital B. We name it as capital S. It is a basis. It is a basis of V of F. Capital S is a basis of V of F. Capital S is a basis of V of F. So, right, if S is a basis of V of F, then it is very clear S is linearly independent. And dimension of V, again same definition. Dimension means number of elements in basis. So, dimension of V is equals to, here we have n elements, here we have m elements. Total dimension is equals to n plus m. Dimension is equals to n plus m. You have to prove this condition. Dimension of V by W is equals to dimension of V minus dimension of W. Now let us take the RHS. Let us take the RHS. Dimension of V minus dimension of W. Now calculate the value. Dimension of V minus dimension of W. What is dimension of V? N plus M. What is dimension of W? Minus n, which is equals to m. If we prove that dimension of V by W is equals to m, dimension of V by W is equals to m, then automatically dimension of V by W is equals to dimension of V minus dimension of W. So our aim is to show that dimension of V by W is equals to M. If we prove that dimension of V by W is equals to M, So this m is replaced by dimension of v by w, which is equals to dimension of v minus dimension of w. To prove this dimension of v by w is equals to n, let us define the cosets. Let us define the cosets. Define a set capital S dash is equals to gamma 1 plus W, comma gamma 2 plus W, comma and so on, gamma M plus W. Define a set capital S dash is equals to gamma 1 plus W, gamma 2 plus W, and so on, gamma M plus W. You observe that these are cosets. Clearly, S dash is subset to V by W. S dash is subset to V by W. V by W means the set of all cosets. Alpha plus W such that alpha belongs to capital V. This V by W forms a vector space which is known as quotient space. Now we prove that. S dash is a basis of V by W. If S dash is a basis of V by W, then automatically dimension of V by W becomes M. If S dash is a basis of V by W, then dimension of V by W becomes M, because S dash contains M elements. So, what is the definition for basis? You have to show that it is linearly independent set and it spans L of S dash is equals to V by W. You have to show that S dash is linearly independent and L of S dash is equals to V by W. Yes. The first side heading, to prove that S dash is linearly independent. To prove that capital S dash is linearly independent. To prove that S dash is linearly independent, consider an equation A1 into gamma 1 plus W plus A2 into gamma 2 plus W plus and so on plus AM into gamma M plus W is equals to 0 bar plus W. Why you take here 0 bar plus W? 0 bar plus W is 0 element. 0 bar plus W is 0 element in V by W. Please note this point. 0 bar plus W is 0 element in V by W in the quotient space. 0 bar plus W is the 0 element in V by W. We know that coset scalar multiplication property. By applying scalar multiplication property, A1 gamma 1 plus W plus A2 gamma 2 plus W plus and so on plus AM gamma M plus W is equals to 0 bar plus W. 0 bar plus W. We know that one basic fact, the scalar multiplication of a coset, some A into alpha plus W is equals to A alpha plus W. A into alpha plus W is equals to A alpha plus W. We use the same operation in every step. A1 into gamma 1 plus W. A1 gamma 1 plus W. A2 into gamma 2 plus W. A2 gamma 2 plus W. Plus and so on, plus AM into gamma M plus W, AM gamma M plus W. We use the same condition. Observe that. And then, again, we know that coset addition. Alpha plus W plus beta plus W is equals to alpha plus beta plus W. This is known as coset addition. Alpha plus W plus beta plus W is equals to alpha plus beta plus W. Apply this property to this equation. You get simply A1 gamma 1 plus A2 gamma 2 plus and so on plus am gamma m plus w is equals to 0 bar plus w plus 0 bar plus w. Again there is one more property, alpha plus w is equals to beta plus w implies and implied by alpha minus beta belongs to w. Again I use the results here, please observe that results. If you understand the results, then these steps are very simple. Observe that alpha plus w is equals to beta plus w implies and implied by alpha minus beta belongs to w. The whole term is alpha. Here it is 0 bar. Here it is 0 bar. By applying the same property here, you get simply a1 gamma 1 plus a2 gamma 2 plus and so on plus am gamma m belongs to w. Am gamma m belongs to w. And it has a basis. Capital B is equals to beta 1, beta 2 and so on beta n is a basis of w. Is a basis of W. Now you observe that there is a property. Every element of the vector space can be written as linear combination of elements of basis. Every element of the vector space can be written as linear combination of elements of basis. By applying that property here, this term can be written as a1 gamma 1 plus a2 gamma 2 plus and so on plus am gamma m is equals to b1 beta 1 plus b2 beta 2 plus and so on plus bn beta n, bn beta n is equals to 0 bar. Bn beta n is equals to bn beta n is equals to, that's all, not equal and that's all. Let us shift the all the terms into right side. Left side a1 gamma 1 plus a2 gamma 2 plus and so on plus am gamma m minus b1 beta 1 minus b2 beta 2 minus and so on minus bn beta n is equals to 0 bar. Now you observe that here the vectors gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma n, beta 1, beta 2 and so on beta n are elements of S. Alpha is and beta is are elements of S and capital S is linearly independent. Alpha is and beta is, I mean not alpha is, I'm sorry, these are gamma is. Gamma is and beta is are elements of S and S is linearly independent. By applying the definition of linearly independence, the scalars involved in this equation are equivalent to 0. What it means? A1 is equals to 0, A2 is equals to 0 and so on, AM is equals to 0. B1 is equals to 0, B2 is equals to 0 and so on, Bn is equals to 0. Now you observe that from this equation, A1 into gamma 1 plus W plus A2 into gamma 2 plus W plus and so on plus Am into gamma n plus W is equals to 0 bar plus W implies A1 is equals to 0, A2 is equals to 0 and so on, am is equals to 0. This is the very very important point. From this expression we said that capital S dash is linearly independent. That is the definition of linearly independent set of vectors. So S dash is linearly independent. Now it is remaining to prove that L of S dash is equals to V by W. Observe that. To prove that, second case number 2, to prove that L of S dash is equals to V by W. What is L of S dash? Linear span. L of S dash means linear span of S dash. Linear span means the set of all possible linear combinations. Of elements of S dash. So what? Since S dash is subset to V by W, which implies L of S dash is also subset to V by W. let it be equation number 1. We prove the converse also. Let us take an element. Gamma plus W belongs to V by W, comma where gamma belongs to V. Let us take gamma plus W belongs to V by W, where gamma belongs to V. Since gamma belongs to V and capital S is equals to beta 1, beta 2 and so on beta n, gamma 1, gamma 2 and so on gamma m is a basis of V. Observe that gamma is a vector of V and beta 1, beta 2, S is a basis of V. We know that every element of the vector space can be written as a linear combination of elements of basis. I repeat, every element of the vector space can be written as linear combination of elements of basis. So gamma can be written as linear combination of beta is and gamma is, which implies gamma is equals to C1 beta 1 plus C2 beta 2 plus and so on plus Cn beta n plus D1 gamma 1 plus D2 gamma 2 plus and so on plus Dm gamma m, where Ci's and Di's are scalars belongs to capital F. They are scalars belongs to capital F. So let it be equation number 2. Now you observe that beta 1, I mean capital B is equals to beta 1, beta 2 and so on beta n. It is a basis for W. It means it is subset to W. It means beta 1, beta 2 and so on beta n are elements of W. So one more. We calculate the same thing in the next step. So, right, first you have to calculate gamma plus W. That is the important point. You have to calculate gamma plus W. Gamma plus W is equals to C1 beta 1 plus C2 beta 2 plus and so on plus Cn beta n plus D1 gamma 1 plus D2 gamma 2 plus and so on plus Dm gamma m plus W. Gamma plus W is equals to whole term plus W. Let us apply the addition of cosets. Which implies gamma plus W is equals to, you can write C1 beta 1 plus W plus C2 beta 2 plus W plus and so on plus Cn beta n plus W plus D1 gamma 1 plus W plus D2 gamma 2 plus W plus and so on plus Dm gamma m plus W, which is nothing but definition of addition of cosets. Again, it can be C1 beta 1 plus W, C2 into beta 2 plus W plus and so on plus Cn into beta n plus W plus D1 gamma 1 plus W plus D2 gamma 2 plus W plus and so on plus Dm gamma m plus W. So now we use that fact. What is that? You observe that capital B is equals to beta 1, beta 2 and so on beta n is a basis of W, which is subset to W. So which implies beta 1, beta 2 and so on beta n are elements of W. If these are elements of W, then beta 1 plus W is equals to 0 bar plus W, beta 2 plus W is equals to 0 bar plus W and so on beta n plus W is equals to 0 bar plus W. Now you can use all these results here, beta 1 plus W, beta 2 plus W and so on beta n plus W. It means if you use all these results here, the above equation takes the form. C1 C1 into 0 bar plus W plus C2 into 0 bar plus W plus and so on plus Cn into 0 bar plus W plus D1 into gamma 1 plus W plus D2 into gamma 2 plus W plus and so on plus Dm into gamma m plus W. This is nothing but the whole term becomes WR. In the left side we get gamma plus W is equals to, which implies again gamma plus W is equals to, you observe the fact from here to here it becomes simply W. Actually it is 0, but you can written it as 0 bar plus W. So W plus D1 into gamma 1 plus W plus D2 into gamma 2 plus W plus and so on plus Dm into gamma m plus W. Now you observe that by cancelling W on both the sides, you get gamma is equals to D1 into gamma 1 plus W plus D2 into, so leave it, we can conclude here, this is nothing but linear combination of elements of S dash. This expression is nothing but linear combination of elements of S dash. The set of linear combinations belongs to L of S dash. The set of linear combinations belongs to L of S dash, which implies gamma plus W belongs to L of S dash. Gamma plus W belongs to L of S dash. Let us continue. Therefore, we conclude that gamma plus W belongs to V by W implies same gamma plus W belongs to L of S dash, which implies as V by W is subset to L of S dash. V by W is subset to L of S dash. Let it be equation number 3. From equations 1 and 3, we conclude that L of S dash is equals to V by W. L of S dash is equals to V by W. Now you observe that. Already we prove that S dash is linearly independent. Therefore, capital S dash is linearly independent. And L of S dash is equals to V by W. These two conditions implies as S dash is a basis of V by W. From this we conclude that dimension of V by W is equals to number of elements in S dash, which implies dimension of V by W is equals to number of elements in S dash is nothing but M. Number of elements in V by W is nothing but M. Now you conclude the final result. Already we prove that since dimension of V by W is equals to M, and dimension of V minus dimension of W is also equivalent to M. Combining these two conditions, we conclude that dimension of V by W is equals to dimension of V minus dimension of W. This completes the proof. Hence proved. Observe that this is one of the lengthiest theorems.